Hey middle schoolers, I hope you guys are doing awesome. Today I'm going to show you how to make a one-point perspective road, a road going away from us in space. Okay, it's going to look something like this when we're done. So grab your pencil, eraser, and ruler if you need it, and let's get started. Step one, draw a horizon line. Somewhere at the top third of your page, okay? Step two, throw a vanishing point on there. You've done this before, right? You did this with your house drawing. Third step is to add the road. Using a ruler if you wish, or if you're good at freehanding. Two very straight lines going off to the distance. Now, as you're building up your drawing, you need to add guidelines for the vertical objects. Trees, telephone poles, even horizontal objects as well, like the sidewalk. Okay, so we need to throw some guidelines in there. Guideline number one is going to be for the edge of my sidewalk, right here. Okay, now I'm going to put a row of trees on the right side. So I need two guidelines. One for the bottom of the trees, and two for the top of the trees. Where I'm going to fit my trees in this space here. All right, so tree number one. Nice bushy top. Have fun with that. And now you must make the trunk of the tree vertical. That is a rule in perspective drawing, that anything vertical in real life is going to be vertical in the perspective drawing as well. Next tree, I'm going to place a little bit further down towards the vanishing point, maybe right here. Again, between my two guidelines, touching guideline one, touching my other guideline. All right, again, a vertical trunk. Throw in another tree. And I think I could fit one more in there, lightly. Okay. Telephone poles. Left side, I'm going to put telephone poles. So the bottom guideline is going to go here somewhere. And I'm going to make these fairly tall. So I'm going to make my upper guideline go up pretty high. Okay. Pole part must stay vertical, and the way you can make sure it's vertical is by noticing the edge of your paper. Right, if I make my line parallel to the edge of the paper, my object is going to be vertical. It's going to have vertical edges. Pole, I skip some space. Next pole. Little skinnier. Skip some space. Next pole. About halfway between here and the vanishing point, I go here. Getting real thin here. And again, halfway between here and the vanishing point. Just a single line, and then maybe one, two more single lines. That looks good. Adding some detail to the top. You don't want your drawings to be boring. The more detailed, the more realistic they look. Trying to make your objects get a little smaller each time. Right? That is the real world. As things are further away from us, they get smaller and smaller. We must try to draw that as well. Okay. House or building. I'll throw a little building in here. You guys are pretty familiar with that. It's just a quick, simple little building. And the easiest place to start is with the face facing us. So in most cases, that's just gonna be a rectangle. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw a rectangle in here. Two-story house, it's kind of tall. And the peaked roof. Okay, there we go. Don't worry about overlapping. We're gonna do that in this drawing, and then for your summative as well, for a little bit more advanced drawing, we're gonna do a lot of overlapping and then end up erasing. To make this look dimensional, go ahead and pull a line towards the vanishing point from this bottom corner. Okay, and then from this corner here as well, straight to the vanishing point. And then since we have this peaked roof, there's kind of a two-step process here. From the very peak, make a very flattish line to the vanishing point. We have to decide how deep we want our house to be. So I can either put it in front of this pole here, put like right there, or I could put it behind the pole and make this pole stand out, be visible. I think I'll put it behind the pole. So right here, I'll make my back edge, trying to keep it vertical. I know my lines are a little wonky, but keep that in mind. And then since the front edge of my roof is slanted at this angle, do the same thing with the back edge here. All right, they should be parallel. That's gonna make it look natural. We've got things in place. Before I add details to the house, I'm gonna go ahead and erase these original lines that I don't need anymore. Guidelines and whatnot. It's always important to draw lightly so that when you do erase, it goes away. Right? We don't want a bunch of extra lines on there. So, a few things to remember here. One is to put guidelines in and put your objects between those guidelines. Two is your objects get closer together as they go further away in space. And to put my sidewalk in, right here, I need to do that. So close, 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 very, you know, they're just so far away. And as they gradually get closer to us, these lines get further apart, more space in between them, maybe something like that. So our eye sees things getting closer as they go away from us. And the third thing about drawing things in perspective is their tone is light in the distance and darker as it comes towards you. So we're just going to put a real simple shading job on this drawing when we're done. And I want you to keep that in mind, that things that are far away from us are going to be a little bit lighter in tone. And as they approach us, as they get closer to our eyes, the outline gets a little darker. And the shading gets a little darker. It's called atmospheric perspective. The theory is that as things go away from us, there's more dust and sediment and things in the air, pollution maybe, that causes them to look a little bit more hazy, a little bit less clear and dark and crisp. All right, and then this would be darker. The rest you can kind of figure out on your own, since you're already kind of familiar with how to draw houses, and you know, you can put all these details in yourself. So let's look again at the finished picture. This is what we're going for. You do not have to make yours exactly like mine. In fact, I would encourage you to make something different and original. Maybe you put a different type of tree here, or something else sticking up. Maybe a different type of telephone pole. But the idea is you want vertical things in your picture to bring our eye to the distance. I'm expecting clean, finished drawings, very lightly shaded, not much. And keep in mind to keep that vanishing point light. Don't do something like this. You put a big dot there. That doesn't look very natural. So maybe have a dot at first and then erase it. You want your eye just to have a challenge seeing the very end of that section there, right? Our eyes are strong and focused up here, a little bit softer back in the distance. Okay, best of luck. Enjoy yourselves. Chat at you soon.